Now, children, in the story sums of division, as in multiplication sums also we had learned each word, okay? Here also in all the sums, in all the story sums, each word will come. And you know what is the meaning of each? One, okay? So, the meaning of each is one. Now, what is the difference between story sums of multiplication and story sums of division? In story sums of multiplication, we were finding total number of things. And here, in division sums, we are going to find out how many particular thing is in one group. Okay, so the answer of division is always small. The answer of multiplication is always big. Because multiplication is a repeated addition and division is a repeated subtraction. So, the answer of division is always small. Now, we will go with the sum and then you will understand. Okay?
So, what is the sum given here? Raju's mother buys 56 rose plants. Matlab, Raju ki mother ne kitne rose plants buy kiye? 56. She puts them in 7 equal rows. Now, 56 plants hai aur usko kaise arrange karna hai? 7 rows mein arrange karna hai. Right? So, how many are there in each row? Each row yane ki 1. 1 row mein kitne hai? Wo find out karna hai. So, here 2 things are given. Theek hai? Kya diya hai? Rose plants diya hai aur rows diya hai. R-O-W-S, rows. तो हम ये दो चीज़ से हम लोग स्टेटमेंट बनाएंगे, नंबर ऑफ रोज प्लांट्स एंड नंबर ऑफ रोज, एंड देन वी विल फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी रोज प्लांट्स आर देयर इन ईच रो. कम ऑन नाउ, लेट्स सॉल्व.
So, in multiplication sum also when we were writing the statement, we were finding two things in this question and then we were writing the statement. In division sums also we'll be doing the same thing. Two things we are going to find out and then we'll make the statement. So what we are going to make the statement over here? Number of rose plants. How many are there? In your textbook when you will see, it is 56. And another thing, what is given? Number of rose. So that we are going to write here, number of rows. How many are there? 7. Okay. So total is given here. In multiplication, we were finding out the total. Right? But in division sum, total will be given to us and we have to find out that how many rose plants are there in one row. There are 7 rows. So how you are going to divide the rose plants in 7 rows and how many plants are there in one row. So for that, we are going to divide our sum like this. 56 we are going to put inside because this is the total given here. And we have to divide this 56 into 7 rows. Now when we say the table of 7, then when in 7 table, when 56 comes, 7 eighths are 56. So children, in one row, how many rose plants are there? 8 rose plants. So here we are going to write down answer. Very simple. 8 rose plants. Because here in question, after how many it is written, how many plants are there in each row? Matlab, ek row ke andar kitne plants, agar hum log ne divide kiya 56 ko, to ek row mein kitne plants honge? 8 rose plants. So simple, you have to write down 8 rose plants. Okay, now next sum.
Okay, now what is the sum given? There are 60 biscuits arranged equally in 6 boxes. How many biscuits are there in each box? ठीक है, तो कितनी बिस्किट्स है? डिवीजन के सम्स में हमेशा टोटल हमको दिया होता है और हमको एक चीज का फाइंड आउट करना होता है. तो यहाँ पे क्या दिया है? 60 बिस्किट्स दिया है. कैसे रखे 60 बिस्किट? 6 बॉक्सेस में रखे हैं, राइट? 60 बिस्किट्स को डिवाइड इक्वली डिवाइड करके सिक्स बॉक्सेस में अरेंज किया है, तो हमको फाइंड ये करना है कि एक बॉक्स में कितने बिस्किट्स हैं। तो चलो लेट्स मेक द स्टेटमेंट।
Now in this sum, children, here also two things are given, that is number of biscuits and number of boxes. So these two statements we are going to make first. Number of biscuits how many are there? 16. And number of boxes. So 60 biscuits are to be divided into 6 boxes. ये 60 biscuit को हमको 6 box के अंदर divide करना है, तो हमको ढूंढना है कि एक box के अंदर कितना biscuits fit होता है, right? So here also we will make this house. Okay, 6 tens are 60. Okay. So in one box there will be how many biscuits will be there in one box? 10 biscuits. So in answer just write down 10 biscuits. Okay, so this way we will first write down the statement. Below that we are going to write down the sum, and below that or on the side you can write down the answer.
Okay, now here it is given 64 pencils were given equally to 8 children. Okay, तो total कितनी pencils थी? 64 pencils थी, और कितने बच्चों में बांटा? 8 children में, right? How many did each child get? मतलब one चाइल्ड को कितनी पेंसिल्स मिली वो हमको फाइंड आउट करना है, राइट? सो हियर पेंसिल्स इज गिवन एंड चिल्ड्रन इज गिवन, सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस वी विल मेक द स्टेटमेंट्स।
नाउ नंबर फिफ्थ सम, व्हाट इज गिवन? हियर आल्सो टू थिंग्स आर गिवन, पेंसिल्स इज गिवन एंड चिल्ड्रन इज गिवन। सेम वे व्हाट वी आर फाइंडिंग इन द मल्टीप्लिकेशन सम, सेम टू थिंग्स जो हम लोग दो चीज ढूंढते थे मल्टीप्लीकेशन सम्स में, वही दो चीज हमको डिविजन सम में भी ढूंढना है, और वो चीज को लेकर हमको स्टेटमेंट बनाने हैं। तो हियर व्हाट इज गिवन, नंबर ऑफ पेंसिल्स इज गिवन एंड नंबर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन इज गिवन। सो वी विल राइट डाउन हियर नंबर ऑफ पेंसिल्स हाउ मेनी? 64। एंड नंबर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन हाउ मेनी? 8. Now we are going to do our sum. 8 are 64. Okay, and here we are going to write down the answer. 8. How many did each child get? 8 pencils. Eight. You can write down simply 8 pencils. Okay. Now three sums I had already explained you. Two sums you tried by your own. Okay, children. Bye.